Hey guys, Mr.III here, and today I'm gonna show you how to turn this into this and finish off with a mask. So, if you like me or what I'm about to do, don't forget to hit that like, subscribe, and enjoy seeing how to make this. So if you're having any trouble finding a mask and want to find something that's a little more protective than just a scarf or bandana, this may be your option. And what it is a MERV 13 air filter, which actually does block the virus particles. And right now, in my opinion, it's close to an N95 if you correct a good seal. The level of difficulty on making this mask is about a medium, because you know, you'll have to cut some wires, fabric, figure out how to use a stapler, and then finish off with this. So you may prick your finger a few times with the wires. Just a heads up. And no, I have not clinically checked this out to make sure it actually blocks everything, so just a disclaimer there. But if companies say this type of air filter can block the virus or bacteria and allergies, I'm gonna give it a shot. I think it's the way to go. And also feel free to do your own modifications. Since this does not have any extra fabric on it and it's just two layers, it's a little fuzzy. So if you do have a little facial hair, but you can't have a beard because that doesn't create a full seal, you may get a little fluff. But just demonstrating how does it look on me. It looks like this. And feels pretty good. Not blocking my breathing and smells like an air filter. All right, so if you guys want to build one of these yourself, enjoy the video and tell me in the comments how yours turn out. And to be honest, if you don't have a 3D printer, this is the way to go. Since people actually made masks with 3D printers using these filters for the masks as well.
And here are the supplies that you need. Or sort of need. Starting off, we've got our air filter. And as you can see, it's a 16 by 25 by 1. The other side does not have any metal, which is good for us. But we're going to have to peel back and cut some of the other ones later. But right now, we're going to take apart the boxed frame, which can be a little difficult since the glue is pretty tough. But don't worry about the edges. We'll just cut them off with the scissors. The last step, just peeling off the last of this. You may get some cardboard stuck if you're not patient enough. And this is the effect of using a heat gun, so you don't want to use that. It'll just shrink it and almost looks like I melted the fabric there. So we're going to give it a few little stretches here, get out those waves or wrinkles you want to call it. Measure our dimensions, which mine were 8 by 16. So 8 up, 16 across. After you finish cutting out the piece, don't forget to cut back a little border that you have on the edge. So you just clip only the wire mesh and leave the fabric, so you have about an inch and a half border, which is needed for a hot glue stage. And there's our piece that we finish off with, which later on I decided to fold up and cut and make into two, which kind of made more sense. So you got yourself a nice little perfect square, an 8x8. Which then you make a little sandwich. Not that way, but you flip it over with both wire sides touching each other. Just like that. But as you can see, with just taking your fist, you can mold your shape and make the final product that way. But I found that using a Clorox wipe container worked actually the best and got the shape that I wanted. Just a quick press just like that. Pretty easily done, and as you see where my thumbs are, that's where your nose would be. And then you can just play around with the shape until you get exactly the fit you want. So you can even just try it out there. Next, we're gonna start cutting out around and just get the mask shape and cut off the excess fat, you know? Stuff we don't need. But that's our little border that we made, that inch to inch and a half. But that just makes everything smooth and we don't have to worry about cutting any wires. So it helps with fitment, and also when we use the hot glue, that'll prevent us from actually pricking our face. So it gets any pointy wire sticking out from the end that's not connected to anything. For everything else, mask looks pretty good right now. Currently, I'm cutting my elastic bands. They're the fabric type that you can use to make stretchy pants or shorts. And the best way to cut this for dimension-wise is actually just to take it from the back of your head and to the front and just go by that, because you want your bottom to be a little shorter than your top since it has a little more. But two, this matters, you know, by the elasticity that's in your stretch band. Now it's the hot glue time. So you just put a bead of hot glue all the way around and then press it down. If you're worried about how hot it is, you can use some types of pliers here. But the thing is, what I found the best is just using your fingers. It was not really hot, to be honest, but just a fair warning, you may burn yourself if you get the excess glue on your finger. But now you can just trim the hot glue, or now it's actually cold glue, and get any of the extra bumps out of the way so you give yourself a nice clean look. And then we're ready for attaching the straps, which is pretty easy. You just get one strap about an inch over, take the stapler and apply a little force and clip it. You want to make sure the head of the stapler is inside the mask because it prevents you from actually having the other prongs poke you in the face, so they're on the outside for safety reasons. But this also may be a little tricky and time consuming there, just to make sure you get that right staple. But once you get all four in, you can also take those pliers and give it a good squeeze to make sure it's nice and firm, won't slide out, and that gives us our finished product right there. In my eyes, it almost looks, you know, professionally on the shelf there. Could sell them in the stores. But as I also said in the beginning, it's a little fuzzy. And if you want to add another layer of fabric to prevent that from getting on you, go ahead. Hope this video helps you out. And don't forget to like and subscribe. There are many other ways to make a mask. Just here's my style.